I could see it in his face. He didn't say it, but I pretty well figured it out. I was talking to a gentleman
at our Rotary Club who was just giving a pitch about a
particular project that he was trying to, obviously, as they do, try to pitch and see if we could support that project. Well, I happened to see a very unique possibility, and so I just went up to him and I gave him my card and said, I think I can help you. And I said, you know, what you're talking about is can be really done with a podcast. And all of a sudden, he kind of flinched a bit and said, "Oh well, yeah, we're thinking about that, but well, you know, there would be so much involved in getting it doing." And I said, "No." I said, "Can you talk on the telephone? Can you talk on the telephone? If you can talk on the telephone, you can do a podcast." And that's true, and it's true for you. But I think there was something else involved. That is, he was afraid. He just had never done that before. And since he tends to be a little bit shy, I can tell that, he was afraid. He was fearful. And so he probably won't come back to me. And that's sad, because in today's world, that is one of the greatest opportunities to build your brand, to build your company, and to enhance your career. It truly is a no-brainer, but most people will never do it because they're afraid, or they don't know how, or they just don't get around to it. Well, I'd like to tell you why today, and we're going to do this every Wednesday, a little bit about the world of sound, and why you don't need to do a podcast, maybe. Maybe you shouldn't be on the radio, maybe. But in today's world, you have to understand how it works, because that will be the world of communication that you will live in and build your business and seek to build your career. And just as Dale Carnegie said 80 years ago, hey, if you want to make it today, if you want to win friends and influence people, you need to learn to be a public speaker. And he was right then, and of course, Toastmasters has served the world for many, many years. Today, it's similar, but it's different. If you want to build a career or build a business, you're going to have to learn how to use the radio and video media. That's the deal, and that's the story for today on Interesting Ideas. I don't know where the idea came from, but I remember participating in it at one time. And I actually can't figure out where I came down on it. But what happened was they asked the question, if you had to lose the one of the senses, which would you be okay with losing? You know, if you had to lose one, you might. Well, what about the sense of sight? What about the sense of hearing? And if you had to choose between being deaf or choosing to be blind, you had to choose one or the other, which would you prefer that it be? And I really, you know, I don't want either at all. And so I can never really think that through. But I have learned something that perhaps will help me, because, you know, if I were blind, I could still be on the radio. And as Rush Limbaugh proved, if you were deaf, you could still be on the radio. And that may help solve part of the problem. But here's where we're going. I want you to understand that the audio sound is very vital. And so if you'll just give me a few minutes on Wednesday to make my point, because I think it'll help you. Because first of all, I want you to realize that you need to know it. Second, I want you to put away your fears. Don't be afraid. You don't have to worry about that anymore. And I can prove that to you by demonstrating it to you. And then we will see where that will lead us. Now, Years and years ago, the master teacher Jesus of Nazareth and the followers of the book that came out said something like this: faith comes by hearing. Now, you have to keep in mind that reading was developed long after hearing. Of course, hearing was one of our most important senses. It was the thing that would help save us. You know, we're going to hear the lion tooth, you know, the saber-toothed tiger come probably before we can see him. And so knowing how to have a sense of sound was very, very, very vital. And so that's the case. And the actual, you know, taking the words and putting them into writing and then being able to communicate by reading what somebody else has written is a very, very recent phenomenon. And in many parts of the world, guess what? Literacy is not a majority of the people. Yes, still today, a lot of people can't read. They don't have the ability to read. And so a lot of good stuff that they should learn or should hear can't be communicated to them. Now, you've heard it said many times, you know, storytelling is the most effective means of communication. But you forgot that story, and this, I took a man to task for this, and he didn't like it, but I was gentle enough about it, and he finally got the point when he saw it, because he was highly educated, and he loved books, and he read books, and he forgot that most people don't do that in the world. They can't. And so, in effect, take the idea that when you say storytelling, it might mean just that. Not story writing or story reading, but storytelling. Faith and trust comes by hearing. We've also discovered that it is the sound that tends to motivate us. The part of the brain that helps sense the sound of things is the part of the brain that tends to lead to greater action and emotion. Now, you can create emotion by the words, but as I'm reading about Marlon Brando, the emotion was in the telling and the speaking and in the performing. In fact, Marlon Brando had his greatest breakthrough in a play that ended with him giving such a loud, primal, crying scream that the audience was mesmerized. Everybody was talking about the scream. And remember, you've seen that painting. And that was the thing that people said, the man is an actor, the man is a performer, because in one of the early plays he was in, he did a scream. I'm just trying to get you to think about the fact that sound is vital. It is very vital. And of course, once you put sound with motion and action, which of course is the essence of television, that makes it even more powerful. But we all know the problem can be is when the sound goes out in the television, it's obviously very, very hard. But we also know that there can be no sight and there can be no visual, but with sound, still many, many things can happen. And what we're trying to point out today to people is that if you are in the book business, You also have to be in the podcast business. We all know now that the audio book is as common as the regular book. And in fact, Amazon finally had to back down a few years ago because in their audio books, Audible, they would say, well, first of all, you have to write a book, a real book, and then we can turn it into an audio book. Well, you don't have to do that anymore. You can actually start with an audio book. In fact, there are now authors and podcasters, and there will be people like me who we don't want to write a book. We want to perform a story, to perform a presentation, to speak it. And we don't want to go through the trouble of having to write it. We simply want to present it to the marketplace as an audio radio performance. Now, not just reading a book, that's different. And many audio books fail because it is just somebody, and oftentimes it's a pretty good professional somebody, but they're actually reading the book. And of course, the difference between reading the book well and perhaps performing the book or the story is something else and very, very different. In effect, how many corporate memos are sent that nobody reads? As I say, a memo is basically a dead tree. It's on a piece of paper. It has no energy, it has no emotion, it has no personality. It is the same thing as a nice flyer or brochure. It may be very colorful and very nice and very pretty, but it's a dead tree. It is the voice, and perhaps the voice and the video that brings it to life. So every Wednesday, we're going to talk about why you need to know and how you can become a man or woman who performs and speaks and teaches and reaches the world and builds their business because they learn the art of making good sounds. Making good sounds. So that's what Wednesdays are going to be about from now on. And I'm going to be here to help you get started on sounding well. Interesting ideas, for sure. And we'll be right back. Okay, here's an assignment for you, all right? First of all, choose one of your favorite stories, or choose one of your favorite books. Or, if you have children, do what you have done hundreds of times. You've read the book to them. Now, if you're like me and my younger parenting, was it good enough to read the book once and the children said, oh, good. Now we won't have to read that book again. Of course not. You know, how many times we would read the story and tell the story and somewhat perform the story over and over again. Now I want you who are a reader, and you who are literate, and you who are really good at that, perhaps you even write well, I want you to think about the book or the story or whatever is that you read, you liked, you thought it was pretty good, and I want you to just take it and then read it with energy and power and emotion as best you can. Perform it. I want you to do that. I also want you to do this. I want you to see what could happen if all of a sudden you start to listen to the radio commercials. Now, the problem, as most radio advertisers know, is that most people ignore the commercials. But I want you to listen to them and see, be very aware when the commercial comes. What do you see? Okay, you know you are hearing something, but now pay attention. And what image comes to your mind when you hear a radio commercial? Now, if you want to understand how to do life and business today, if you want to, here we go. You know, here's what Dale Carnegie said: win friends and influence people. And today, Stan Houston's new version of that book is How to Make Good Friends and Serve Your Audience. Serve your audience. In effect, what would you start to do? What would you start to do? Well, there we are. Thank you for taking time to listen. Please reach out to me, because we're going to teach you how to be successful on our radio programs. And then, of course, we have a YouTube channel, and we have all of that available at witradio.net, witradio.net. We're going to teach you how. Don't be afraid. You can do it. In fact, not only you can do it, in many cases, you must learn to do it. And if you want to understand how the world works today, you at least may not have to be a doer, but you're going to have to be an understander. Think about it. Talk about it. Maybe you get two or three other people who want to be successful in their career, and you said, you know what? One of our projects is, we're going to learn how we can build our business, or how we can be really good being a plumber or a lawyer or a teacher, by learning how to use the radio and television in our life and business today. So reach out to me, Stan@witradio.net, Stan@witradio.net. I'm here to help you, and you need some help. I guarantee it. Take care. Best and blessings. And see, I can say that. All the best and blessings to you. Don't be afraid. You don't need to be. Take care. Be safe. Ride tall. But take a few risks today. It'll do you good. Bye for now.